4 years, Jim's life and health, and I had a two-year-old, and so there was other things that I think I had to take care of. But once those were kind of off the plate and settled, that's when I began. It was actually something having to do with my son, who by that time was about 5 or 6. We were getting into a friend's pickup truck out in the Midwest to go swimming, and Scott sat on the seat, a little tiny thing, and picked up what we all thought was a toy gun. And I reached over to show him never to point even a toy at anybody, took it from him, and it was a little tiny Saturday Night Special. Laying on the seat, the driver of the pickup truck said he just kept it for protection. I came back to Washington a couple days later, and the NRA, there was a story on the news about the NRA fighting to get rid of the 1968 Gun Control Act. So I picked up the phone and called them. It was after dinner, and I don't know who I got, just probably a security man or a sweeper or something. And I said, I'm going to make it my life's work to try and get rid of the NRA. And that was it.
What do you think it's going so far?
Well, there are ups and downs, and like anything else. Today, it's a little bit of deja vu. The same arguments, the same... the NRA is giving the same reasons why we shouldn't do something. It's, but I'm pleased to be here in Maryland because it is a state that has set a standard. They were one of the first in public safety, and passing their Saturday Night Special ban. I started. That was our first state victory, and here in Maryland that Jim made his first public statement, because we were here the night it passed, and Jim gave a big thumbs up at the press conference.
That was back in early 90s or late 80s?
Late 80s.
I was not living in Maryland at the time.
Mm-hmm. Late 80s.
88. What are your impressions of the bill Governor O'Malley has proposed?
Oh, I think it's an excellent package. It's very comprehensive. The licensing for handgun purchasers is very well done because it's got teeth in it with the fingerprinting, with the getting your license from the state police, and with the safety training. It really deters any straw purchasers from trying to purchase guns. And without the teeth in it, it wouldn't be as effective.
And for those who say the licensing requirements are too burdensome, too much of a financial burden, we've had Republicans who actually compared this to a poll tax. What do you say to that?
Well, I think they're going to be able to work out the finances pretty well. I think that should be a minor issue in thinking of public safety. If they need a gun, they can get a long gun, a rifle, a shotgun. They don't have to go through this. But for a handgun, it's a very important thing. That's the weapon of choice in most of these shootings. And it's something that just really needs to be taken seriously. Just anybody shouldn't be able to purchase something without knowing how to use it and proving who they really are. That's public safety.